And our speaker today is Ekaterina Glinina with a talk on construction of the space of functionals from point measures in the Aratia flow. Please, Katya.
Thank you for opportunity to have a talk here. And okay, I will start from the from the state of the problem that we will consider today. So let me be a locally finite to a point process or a random point measure on the real line. And if we define the sigma field of all measurable events with respect to measure mu as follows. Then the question is, does the linear combination of multiple integrals with respect to measure mu are dense in the space of linear or space of random variables with the second moment and that which are measurable with respect to this sigma field. So this is a general problem, and now I will talk about the measures which we are interested in. So we will consider the Aratia point measure. So this is the point measure that counts the number of points at time t in the Aratia flow. So formally it is defined as follows. So we just count the number of points of the Aratia flow that starts from each point of the line and at time t came to set delta. It is known that for a bounded subset of a real line, such a number of points is finite, so this measure is well defined. So our problem is to prove the previous statement, this about the density of multiple integrals for this point measure of the Aratia flow. And today on this talk, I will illustrate the known result in this field on the Poisson point process. So I just give here a definition for recall that we will consider the simple case when a point process has a Poisson process has Lebesgue measure of intensity. So we have such distribution of number of points in the subset delta. And for this processes for point process the result is known. So I will illustrate the main problems on this example. So before I start to discuss the main problem, I would like to give a strict definition of multiple integrals with respect to random point measures. And for this, I will start the discussion from the so-called factorial power of point processes, because they are most useful in the multiple, in defining the multiple integrals. So the factorial power of the point measure of the such a form here, k may be equal to infinity, so it's allowed as well. So for such a point measure, factorial powers or factorial measures can be defined as following equality. So we just need to sum all delta measures of m points such that indexes are not equal.
Katya, in J1 is not equal to Jm2. Is it correct? So not only, so this means that all indices are distinct.
Yes, yes, that's right. So they all distinct, yes. And also today we will use usual power of the measure. So this is like from definition of the product of measures. So this is the usual definition of product of measures. And I give the representation again in the term of delta measures here. And you can see that now indices in the sum are all, but for factorial power, we consider just that indices that are not equal one to another. So this is the main difference. we can define the moments of this factorial powers of the measure, and it turns out that they are the most useful tools in the investigation of the point measures. So we will say that the factorial moments is defined as moment of factorial power of the measure mu. And if this measure has density with respect to Lebesgue measure, we will say that this density rho is the endpoint density of the measure mu. Sometimes it called as correlation function. So from the definition, we can write the moments in terms of such an integrals with respect to some to this functions. So actually, to characterize the properties of point process, the main problem is to find this endpoint densities. And it turns out that for the Ratio point process, they exist and have a specific form. But first, on the simple example of the Poisson point process. So if we have a Poisson process with Lebesgue measure of intensity, then its nth factorial measure just equal to usual power of Lebesgue measure. So, and so it has the density equal to 1. And a much more difficult question was about the Aratia point process, and it was solved by Tripp and Zaboronsky, who found the form of the endpoint densities in terms of Pfaffians of specific e-kernels. So here I gave the form of the kernels, but I will not use them during my talk, so I will not give a precise definition of Pfaffian of the matrix. I will use just some upper bounds for these functions. So now we can define the multiple integrals with respect to a point process, and I give the statement for for definition of multiple integrals with respect to Aratia point measure. So if we can define these integrals for functions from L2 on 0, 1 to the power k, and so this integrals will define a continuous operator from the space L2 to probability L2 omega fp. The main property of the point process that we used here to prove that these integrals are well defined is the upper bounds for endpoint densities of the following form. So if we have here such a uniform upper bound for all moments or for all endpoint density, this means we have an upper bound for all n factorials moments of measure mu t. And another fact that is used here, that we can rewrite the integrals with respect to usual power as a linear combination of integrals with respect to factorial powers of some point measure. So this is even non-random equalities. So if we have some point measure, we can rewrite these types of integrals, and these constants here do not depend on function f and measure n, so they are just combinatorial constants. And using this fact, we can see that the density of multiple integrals in some space is equivalent if we will consider multiple integrals with respect to factorial power or with respect to usual power. So it is the same. Okay, so now I would like to say about known result about the Poisson process. So for Poisson process, this question is solved, and it is known that the multiple integrals are dense, and moreover, it is known the kernels of the integrals. So let us consider, let us define a multiple integrals for symmetric functions with respect to a Poisson process of the following form. Here, what is written, I will use this notation. So I have some measure of function f, and if I write some measure of function f, this means the integral of f with respect to measure mu. So we have such a linear combination of integrals with respect to factorial powers of a Poisson process and of usual power of the Lebesgue measure. Such a linear combination was chosen for to obtain the property that these integrals are centered. So for Poisson process, we will have such a property if we define the integral as linear combination of such form. So as example, if I consider multiple integrals of order 2, then I have such a form for symmetric function f. Okay, so and these integrals also are orthogonal for different order. So this is the main properties of such definite multiple integrals with respect to Poisson process. So this allows to define a chaotic representation for functionals that are measurable with respect to a Poisson process. So it is known, and this chaotic expansion has a such form, and here kernels in the integrals are known and have a specific form of such kind. So we need to take such discrete derivatives of functions with respect to measure. Oh, I have here mistake here. Not new. And these derivatives, the expectation of derivatives are the kernels in this chaotic expansion in the case of the Poisson process. So this result is known for Poisson process. But let me give you some example of the chaotic representation of some functionals of a Poisson point process. So the first example is the following. If I consider a positive function v with this compact support, and I consider exponent with minus integral of v with respect to Poisson point process, Then it is not hard to see that this derivative has the following form. So it is not difficult to calculate its expectation. Here we have just expectation of initial functional. And a little bit of transformation will give us such chaotic expansion. So this is just a factorial, just multiple integrals with respect to factorial power of Poisson process here. So we have this form for such functional. And if we consider another example, which is given here. So let us consider the first point on the positive half line in the Poisson process. So if I have zero, and here I fix the first point in the Poisson process here. So again, we can find the this discrete derivatives, and they have the following form. So we have non-zero values only for those points x which are of this kind, so all of them here, x1, x2, for example. And taking expectation, so it is not hard to see that the expectation of this derivatives is equal to such a value. And so we know the kernels in the Hallis expansion of such function, and we know that this is exponentially distributed random variable, so we can write it as sum of integrals with respect to Poisson process. Okay, now, I'm sorry, let us come back to the main problem that we are interested in. This is the case of the Ratio point process. And now, here the main difference of with the Poisson process is that that's much more difficult to find the orthogonality of multiple integrals with respect to factorial powers of measurement. But nevertheless, we have the result that the linear combination of multiple integrals with respect to measure mu t, so with respect to Ratio point process, are dense. So this means that we have such representation for a random variable which is measurable with respect to sigma algebra generated by measure mu t. And I would like to say how we can prove this result. And first of all, note that if we consider a space of finite measures on the interval, for example, on a finite interval 0, 1 with such distance, Then this space is complete and separable. And from this follows that if I consider the restriction of the Ratio point measure on some finite interval, then this is a random element in this space, and from this follows that if I consider a random variable that is measurable with respect to such sigma field, then it can be represented as a function of measure mu. So from this follows that I can here in my representation, I can write the form as in here f from mu t. Okay, so let us now consider the case of the restriction of the measure mu t on some finite interval. Then we can represent this sigma field using integrals with respect to measure mu of dense set of function in the space of continuous functions in on the interval from minus m to m. And now let us know that the polynomials of this integrals are just multiple integrals with respect to measure mu t, because we have here a product, some products of integrals, and they are represented as a linear combination of multiple integrals with respect to factorial powers of measure mu t. So if we will prove that this random vector such that the polynomials of it are dense in the space of measurable random variables with respect to its sigma algebra, then we will prove that multiple integrals with respect to measure mu t restricted on finite interval are dense. So to prove this statement, I will use the following proposition that says that if we have some random vector eta, and let us consider, and then the polynomials of this random vector are dense in the space of random variables that are measurable with respect to this sigma algebra. If the characteristic function of this random vector is analytic in the neighborhood of zero. So we will need to, we need to prove this statement for our case, and we will use the following criteria to check that the characteristic function is analytic is in the neighborhood of zero. So we need to prove that the moments of integrals with respect to ratio point process has such upper bound. So to do this, So let us recall that now I can see such a random vector that consists on the integrals with respect to radio point process. And then I can estimate the case moment of this vector as following. So recall that functions f are continuous, so they are bounded with some constants. So I write here the constant that is depend on the dimension of this vector and on.
Okay, and R supports of fk is zero. So supports of fk belong to 0, 1. Is it correct?
No, they are in minus mm.
Okay, but they have finite support.
Yes, yeah, yes.
If a minus mm, then you need to write mu t from minus mm two. Yes. Mm-hmm. Minus mm.
Okay, right. Okay. Mm-hmm. Oh, to write here the constant that is dependent of. Okay, but now the we know that. The moments of factorial powers of, if I will write here M,
mm-hmm.
Less or equal than some constant here, and I need to multiply here. So, okay. Okay, we have such a constant for factorial powers of the measure mu, but we need to have the upper bound for usual power of the measure here. So to do this, I use the connect the following connection between U powers. So we can rewrite the usual U power of number as following sum of power of factorial U powers of the number, where the here the factorial power is defined as the following. So this is the same as if I will write factorial power of for example 0, 1, then this is from the definition just here. So I use this equality, but also I need to know the upper bound for the constants, and they are also known. I can just use the following upper bounds, so they can be estimated as following. So here is binomial coefficients multiplied by the by this power, and using this observation that we have for yod from 1 to k, then we can get the following upper bound for moments of the vector eta that is from the integrals with respect to measure mu. So we have some constant here. Again, I forgot here, I have initially k, so. And we can see that k's disappears, and we have such a formula for upper bound for moments. So from this, we have the following conclusion that the polynomials of integrals with respect to measure mu are dense in the space of square integrable random variables which are measurable with respect to this sigma field. Now to obtain the main statement, we just need to know that the sigma field generated by measure mu can be obtained as minimum sigma field generated by sigma fields of the restricted point processes. And for this, we already get the statement of density of the integrals in the space of measurable random variables. So this proves the statement about the density of this representation here for random variables with respect to the sigma field. So we can write such a representation in terms of factorial powers of measurement. So I think that that's all for today.
Okay, thank you very much. Maybe somebody have questions or comments, please. Katya, may I ask you about the orthogonality? Can we expect that on the fixed T, we will have some system of orthogonal integrals and expect good relationship between the kernels, like in Poissonian case, or of course this is just a simplification, like in Hausdorff case.
Here the main difficulty for orthogonalization is that we have no good property for endpoint densities of the radial point process, because the main property for the Poisson process was that for Poisson we have here a product of just a power of
one point.
One dimension. Yes. So and this is allows to just. Mm-hmm. Allows to find linear combinations of the integrals if I have two dimensional integrals. Is waiting right here. It's one, two, it's two, and one dimensional for simplicity. No, Gx. So we can find linear combination such that the expectation, if I multiply, I can find such a linear combination of this integrals. Maybe I should write here that they are equal to zero. But for the case, so here the idea is to split this endpoint density to the product. But in the case of the Aratia point process, if I have here, for example, I will have, so I cannot represent the product of this type as or linear combination mm-hmm. of this kind. So, and here, if I will have here such a product, For the ratio, so for Poisson process, we can find a linear combination of integrals to get zero. But for a ratio point process, ratio, we will have always there some values of such integrals with respect to this.
But it is not very bad. Can you just show us a formula for orthogonal integrals related to Poissonian process?
They are just linear combination for our previous. I need to delete. Just a
Oh, just this one, yeah. And you see, actually, what we have, we integrate f against part of variables, with respect to this point measure of but. Why we cannot do the same? Just leave this point measure like rho m minus k or something. Maybe.
Because if you write some linear combination for the ratio flow here, mm-hmm. again, if you will try to find the expectation of okay linear combination of one is two, mu two, plus some this respect to mu df.
Maybe even not f, but some linear operator from f, some j, which linear depends on f.
Yes, and then some another phi from. Mm-hmm. Some non-random measure, okay, dx mm-hmm. one, dx two, and if you multiply it by some, okay, just one-dimensional integral with respect to measure mu, then you will have here the integral with some integral some. I can write precisely some integral with some function. Kappa, and here we'll have the third point.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And we cannot split it to the.
Why not? We just can integrate. Integrate this with respect to one variable, then divide and then delete and divide and multiply on this product, for example, row one and row two, and then try to do something. Yeah? Why not?
Maybe, but
It seems to me that we have to try to get the orthogonal part of the multiple integrals.
Mm-hmm.
Because it seems that it must exist. The main problem when we cannot do this is following. Imagine, for example, that you have integral, for example, from the function which depends on two variables, mm-hmm. but you can approximate this integral in L2 sense by the functions which by the integrals from function from one variable. But it seems that this is not our case.
Yes.
So we must have something. Which is orthogonal to the previous powers. So it exists and we must to find it, yeah?
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Can I ask a question? I'm sorry.
Yes.
I'm just trying to in the beginning, I was trying to think about this sigma algebra, and the question is, what happens if we have only a fixed number of points in the point measure, so that we have just fixed number of like 3 points, for example, and they are different. So can we say that the sigma algebra is very simple, can be described easily, and this this is also
these points are random.
Yes, 3 random points. Can we say that sigma algebra is, for example, random variables are just symmetric functions? Can we say that?
So if...
Yes, what happens if we just like have 3 points?
Three. And then, so they are... random variables then the if I have a functional, yes, if I have a psi is a functional or is a random variable that is measurable with respect to sigma field, I write sigma, then psi is a function of this 3 points. Yes, it's one, x, two, x.
Maybe not 3 points. I think, Alexey, it can be a so-called variational series from statistics. Minimal, maximal, and something between. And it must be, yeah? Because this is like empirical distribution of statistics.
Okay, and then this multiple integrals can be easily also.
Yes, written, this is just this.
And it will be it will be finite number of elements in the sum, or maybe infinite.
Yes, yes, you are right, because we know the maximal number of the distinct points.
Yes, so we will have.
Okay, so it will be only 3 maximum, maybe. Okay.
Yes, yes, only 3.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, maybe some other questions or comments, please.
In your formula for Poisson multiple integrals, it looks like you just subtract, when you write multiple integral with respect to the random measure, in each differential, you subtract, in some sense, you compensate by lambda and then expand on this slide. It's like you write eta minus lambda, dx1, dx2, and then expand. In our paper with Professor Dorogovtsev, we did a similar thing in general situation for some transformations of Gaussian processes, and it led to orthogonal integrals. So maybe it can help.
So, and here, is it an integral with respect to compensated Poisson measure?
Yes.
No, here?
Yes.
So here, this formula is just a multiple integral with respect to?
Just with respect to point process, not compensated, because here.
But, you see, we have minus lambda. Georgi was right. I completely forgot our paper, and we have to look on it. And this integral with respect to compensated Poisson.
But also powers are replaced by factorial powers, yes?
Okay, thank you. I will look at that paper. Thank you.
Okay, maybe some other comments. Okay, if there are no comments, then thank you again. And Georgi, maybe you know who is the next speaker.
The next speaker will be Natalia Smorodina. But I don't know the topic yet.
She contacted you. Yes.
Yes. No. Mm-hmm. Not me.
No, not me. Okay. Okay, so please ask her.
Okay.
This is a time when just announce a talk.
Yes, it is important. Yes.
okay. So see you next week. Bye.
Bye.
Goodbye.
Thank you. Bye.